friends, today I have again come up with this story, another story. So the story is of the study of butterfly, the life cycle of a butterfly. And we all know that there are four stages in the life cycle of a butterfly: egg, and then there is the caterpillar, and then there is the pupa, and the butterfly itself or the insect. The teacher was teaching students the life cycle of a butterfly, and the project was that they were studying from the stage of the egg to the butterfly. Now the third stage was ready. Cocoon were almost formed, and some of the cocoons were even ready. The butterfly was ready to come out of the cocoon or the pupa. So naturally it took so many days to study this project, and one fine day the students came, and there were some cocoons broken partly, and the butterfly was trying to struggle from inside to come out. So the butterfly tried coming out, and the students saw, and they were very excited. So they told their teacher that, look, today we will be able to see butterflies. Some cocoons, the butterflies are almost 3/4 out. You can watch all the cocoons and how slowly they are trying to come out. Teacher said, I'm just here, you all watch, but remember not to touch the cocoons. Don't touch the pupa. Don't do anything to them. Sit far and watch. They were watching, and they were writing the notes also. And suddenly they saw that one cocoon, the butterfly was struggling and trying to break the outer cover. And they were very excited because they wanted to see the butterfly. So they thought, they told to each other that, let us break the cocoon, help the butterfly with the cocoon, and it will come out fast. So today, before the class finishes, we will at least be able to see one butterfly. So students, what they did, they got together, they helped the break the cocoon, and the butterfly came out. Butterfly came out and flew here and there, and suddenly she sat and she died. So children were worried. Children went running to the teacher. Our experiment has failed. Teacher said, how? The butterfly has died. So teacher asked, did you touch the pupa? Children said, no. So teacher said, what did you do? No, we just, you know, we did not touch it. We just tried to break the cocoon so that the butterfly doesn't have to struggle much. Children, and that is where you were wrong. Because when the butterfly was trying to come out, its wings were getting stronger. When it was trying to struggle, then its wings would have been stronger. It would have taken more air, and thereby it would have been a strong insect to fly from here to there. By helping break the cocoon, you have actually disturbed the process, and so the butterfly died. Children were sad, but I think the story is for everybody, the teachers out there, because sometimes we are in a hurry to finish the project or finish the work, and some children are slow. And what we try to do? We try to tell the children who are little faster to finish the work of the others also. We are killing that butterfly, which is the pupa, which is coming, you know, the butterfly which is coming out of the pupa, because we are assisting wrongly. We are not giving it time to break cocoon on its own. What about these students? See, you people help your friends because you are in a hurry to go to the ground. Somebody who is struggling with the writing work, and he's good in games, you try to finish his work, and thereby, you know, not let him grow. And even in the examination, you try to help the child out with some answers. And naturally, the child is not able to learn, and you are not doing good to your friend. And now, my dear parents, when a child is given a project or a work, and suppose your child is little slow in work, you get worried and you want your child to get those A grades which you are so worried about and the high marks, you try to help the child by various means. Sometimes you buy the project, sometimes you do their homework, sometimes you get it done from the elder brother or elder sister, and thereby not allow your own child to break the cocoon on its own, where it will be a strong human being. So I have only a message to all those who are concerned directly or indirectly with children, even teachers, those who are learning. If some teachers are helping them by finishing their work and not allowing them to use, for example, now teachers are using technology. Some other teachers will help out of the way, out of friendship. But if you help the teacher to learn from scratch, the teacher will be stronger. But if you are helping the teacher by just adjusting somehow, giving your video to the teacher, or not helping in a way where the teacher can get stronger or anybody learning can get stronger, then what you are doing is a harm to the person. So all those who are learning should remember that there is a time for the cocoon to break, and once the cocoon breaks on its own by the struggle of the learner is strong. See you next time.